Hey guys, welcome back. I'm playing on Foundry by Killmaster. So, this is a port from the original game with some significant graphical updates. Look at this! This is some amazing weather effects in here. It's a shiny floor as well. Okay, so I'm going to have to do some thinning of the numbers, as it were, before I do some decent exploring, but this is really good. I'm liking this. I cannot close the door. Oh well. Can I at least close this one? I can't, okay. Okay, now I can see. Right, let's talk. Oh my god. I was going to say, now I can actually see. Let's talk about the map. Check this out. There's some amazing, amazing mechanical effects here. And of course, we've got some decent texture uses as well. This is good for the floor. We've got some wall detail as well, that's nice. Now hang on. You gotta go. Looks like this door's pretty much closed up. And it's at least it's not like one or two bits of, I don't know, like a table or something up against it. There's all sorts of different things that have been used to block this door off. Hang on, I'm gonna get a lot of this. This is what happens when you guys want me to fight things during a review, rather than leave them alone. Okay. This I wanted to look at. This is really nice. I don't really remember the Foundry map from Killing Floor 1. I don't think it's one of the default ones, I could be wrong, but I certainly haven't played it very much. Oh wow, look at the lighting on this! Check out the heat on that. Okay, we're running low. Running low on Zeds, so that's good. Ah, that's a trader door right there. Everybody knows what the trader door looks like. Okay, you I'm gonna let live. You're annoying. Okay, six left. Ah, the sisters are fine. They walk slow. I like them. Alright, let's have a look at the outside, shall we? Got lots of detail out here. Lots of plants, lots of trees. I like it when effort's being put into the out-of-map areas. I do. So we'll try and explore the ground floor first, before we actually start going up some stairs. Level 1. Alright. Now that's looking a bit flickery from here. Don't know if you can see that right in the centre of the screen there. I think that's a door. It's quite hard to tell because the texture's loading in and out really quick. Ooh, okay. Yeah, I love weather effects. They look really good. And of course, you can see there's a big puddle on the floor here. That looks nice. Okay, now, because it's a Killing Floor 1 map, yeah. That'll be a door I can open and close. That's something I need to remember. So look at these glass shards and everything. That's really good. Considering that water's actually getting through the roof, there's actually some detail here as to why that is. The glass is obviously gone, but where's the glass gone? It's all over the floor. And of course, these shelves are actually stocked up with all sorts of boxes and stuff, and of course some of the boxes are on the floor because they've all been just chucked down somewhere. That's another trader door. Okay. Okay, you can go. Can't have too many of you, sorry. That's nearly all of them. What was that, Industries? Okay, right, what we'll do, let's keep them behind there just for a minute. Ooh, okay. I'll grab a drink while I'm here. Okay, those don't explode. It's worth checking. And there's lots of little extra areas that I don't think I can actually go in that we can see here.
Finish the last ones off.
TV doesn't break. Oh, that's a wall detail here as well. That's all electrical boxes and cables and stuff. That's nice. And of course, just to slow them down a little bit more. There we go. You know, I tried to do that once the demolitions guy ended up ending the wave early. Forget which map that was in. But anyway. Oh, fantastic. Can I actually set fire to myself? Oh well, I can't. It's worth trying, right? Okay, I guess we'll go down to a lower floor first. Forget how big this map is. Oh, and check out this. This is not... Oh, God. Yeah, wear your hard hat or something. Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, that guy's having a bad day, huh? There's so much detail in this map, I don't think I can really spend my time talking about all of it. You'll just have to take it in. God damn. So much work has been put into this, I'm really liking it. And of course, we've got another Z area there. I can't go into that. Oh, looks like I found the route around. Can I go in here? No. Okay, that's the area I was looking at a second ago. You guys are getting a bit aggressive, aren't you? I think they got all excited when they broke the door down, that's not good. Oh. Excuse me. Damn it. Just have to make sure I hit him in the chest and we'll be fine. Look at this. This is definitely a factory. It is definitely a factory. All these pipes and stuff. Alright, let's go back into the metalworks area where I was before. And come on. There we go. Alright, this is where I was before. I couldn't set fire to myself, which was unfortunate. And that's where I went last time, which doubles back around. Okay, so let's see this. This machinery looked very interesting from earlier. Oh man, check this out. I can go quite close to that, can't I? Okay, hang on. First of all, what is actually through here? Okay, that's the area I was in before, because that's the guy who's having a bad day. Let's check this out. Okay, we can't break everything in here, but it's worth trying. Now, this is an office area that I don't think I can get into because those doors are ajar, so... Can I get down here is what I'm really interested to know. Okay, stop that. Two of you I'll leave alive, but other than that, you guys are getting a bit feisty. Okay, I can't jump over the edge. I'm going to have a look at that later, either in another wave or back in later in this one, depending where I end up, but... Wow, that's nice. I'm very impressed with that machine over there. That looks cool. Alright, this is our only way out of here, so I'll tell you what, let's double back through here. There was a lot of detail in this room, and of course... Oh my god. You guys, you've had a lot of training. Who went this way? Where does this go? Oh, just here, okay. So this is where we got to last time. So, we're going to check out the rest of this floor all the way down here before we go upstairs. Let's go back to the entryway and head over this side. Wow, check that out. That's impressive. I get to see a lot of maps doing these reviews. A lot of maps. So, me getting impressed by a map is actually quite something. Because I end up developing this kind of standard to what I think is a good map and what isn't. Oh wow, there's a lot of stuff all over the floor. Lots of clutter. I do like my clutter. But yeah, I mean, some people think certain maps are good, whereas I don't. But I see a lot of maps. A lot. Ah, damn it. Tell you what I'll do. Yeah, I want to actually lock them out of there. So we'll either find another way in, then we'll see where this way goes. Oh, I'm liking the brickwork as well. That's pretty cool. Okay, chemical works. Right. That's what I wanted to do. Oh, wow. Okay. Be careful now. I'm loving this green glow. It's very radioactive. We haven't even, like, finished this floor yet. There's so much more to do. Okay, that's where I was going to lock them out. Yeah, that's going to stay there for a bit. Check this out. I mean, this wall's starting to get a bit plain there, but you do have some lighting here to sort of help with that. And an interesting roof texture as well. Have another look at this. Considering I rewatched Breaking Bad recently, I can't help but think of meth every time I see a blue canister. Oh well. And of course, you can't go anywhere around here at all, but the detail's there. There's some interesting weird machines or something. Now, I'm pretty sure that's the entirety of the ground floor done, so let's go up the floor. Lots of Zed spawn areas as well. Oh, okay, right. Well, they're still down there. Let's check out this sort of control room. Blue screen of death right there, as well as whatever death these guys face. I think they've lost a limb here and there. But this cost them an arm and a leg, didn't it? Alright. Oh! Excuse me. And... Come on. Yes. Just in time. Right, where are we now? We're just above the starting area. And there is another floor. Okay, first of all, I'm pretty sure those stairs there just go down to some other places where I've already been. Check this place out. But I also want to know where places like this go to, so I'll tell you what. Let's weld that again. They're going to catch up otherwise. Have a look around. Level 2. We get a really good view of, like, first of all, the lighting on this is really good. Check that out. And of course, there's a better view of this machinery from here. Okay. I just want to try and break everything. That's pretty much how I play these sorts of games. What can I break? And you get some interesting views of some of the other details on the lower levels here as well. I didn't check if the lift works. I'll have to check that out at some point. There is a lot of dead workmen around here. A lot of dead workmen. Now, a lot of these stairways I've actually seen before. So that's fine. just another way around here. I'm really liking this sort of warm effect you get from that. Either warm or hellish, depends like how dark you want to go with that. There's also lots of nice lighting around here. I mean, not just these as well, but also little lights here and there for added detail. Okay, I can actually jump through that, that's a bit odd. But at least you can't jump on top of it, that'd be a bit weird, wouldn't it? Alright, so that's the entirety of this sort of set of flooring done. So let's go and find the stairs up. Here we go. Let's check this out. They've been stuck on that door for a while, poor guys. Oh, now we get a very clear view of up here. I'm liking the sky as well. We've just got that sort of grey, dull cloud, which England is very famous for. But that may seem a bit odd, but it's very fitting for the kind of feeling of the map. And of course, we've got lots of chimneys and stuff. Also, there's a lot more warehouse out here. Clearly, we're in a massive set of buildings somewhere. Oh god, here they are. Let's go around the other way. There's our trader. And... yeah, they're coming this way. Okay, let's just weld them out again. Honestly, I didn't think picking support would actually be as effective for this as I realised, but... okay. So again, we've got an even higher up view. The starting area. Let's check this out again. Oh wait, they're just gonna walk around if I do that. Whoops! I'm not a smart man, okay? Alright, let's see how far we can go with this. But yeah, this sort of large main room is the majority of the map, and it looks amazing. All sorts of different angles, I'm liking it. Right, what's it gonna be? There we go. So what I wanted to do is actually have another look at this area over here. Like this. Red marks are for. I didn't see them a minute ago, but... yeah, this is really nice. Like, a lot of extra work has been put into the sort of outside of the area that you can't get to, and that's just how it is. Lots of wrecked warehouse areas as well. This area's been like this for a while. Hang on, can I actually get in here? I also like the fact there's a lot of rooms that are in here that you can't get into. It basically keeps the map a reasonable size, but it also shows that there's more to the building than where you can get to. Like, this could just be in a lot of other maps. Just a wall, a blank wall. But no, you've got the room for it, so an extra area, extra detail, extra stuff. I like it. I like these sorts of things a lot. Huh. It is tempting to jump down there, but that's probably a bad idea. I'll end up like one of these guys. Yeah, I'm liking the light shade here as well. That's also very good. Okay, actually, there. This was the area I was in before. So I wonder what this red lighting's for. I'm not entirely sure. However... we've now explored the entire map, so let's do some more fighting in later levels, but for now, see you next wave.
Glad to see you made it through.
Something I wanted to talk about before we get back to the next wave is, of course, we've got the Killing Floor 1 trader. Excellent for a port, but look at all the detail in this room. It's only the trader room, but of course, all the boxes on the shelves there. You've even got like newspapers in the back, London Times and stuff.
I'm about to shut the pod.
Even like routes to potential other areas of the map that we can't get to, of course, but they're there. Goes again to what I was saying of all these extra areas you can't get to that makes the map feel a lot bigger. And of course, the amount of pickups are decent. I'm quite happy with that. There's not too many, there's not too few. Oh god. Made me jump there. Okay. And fortunately, because it's an interior map with lots of different twists and turns, I didn't have any problems getting to the trader. The arrow showed me exactly where I needed to go. Heard that. Where are you? There you are. I see you. Oh, I did it too slow. Way too slow. This is the thing. I've been playing Gmod recently, so alternate fire was aim rather than both barrels, which is unfortunate. What I need to do was this. There we go. That was the correct button. Bloody hell, yeah, I have nearly cleared him out. Something I like doing is doing extra fighting in all the different parts of the map. That's what I like to do, so... let's kill the last few guys in the starting area, shall we? Come on. I did it again, didn't I? God damn. Hey, what? Wow, okay. Right, both barrels for you, you bastard. Couple more things here. Looks like we've got an interesting locker room, so the trade rooms are all different. Also, we've got a webcam, which actually shows what the other room in there. That's actually a screenshot from that. And of course, we've got the dust motes in the lighting, which I haven't noticed before. So, that's interesting. That's really interesting. Like, the effort's gone into make all the trader rooms actually different, which I like. Got some shiny light in there as well. Okay, so let's have a run around while we fight as well. And maybe not, you know, kill everything so fast. That's the problem if you play a lot of this game. Eventually, like, all of your classes get high level. So when you do things like a review, you have to make sure you show as much as you can in the first wave. Otherwise, everything just dies too quick. Right, where's everything at? I think it's all behind me, but I want to have a nice little bit of a run around. Make sure I can actually get through here. Oh, shit! Of course. I sandwiched myself. You know what?
Now finish the job.
Just clear everything up with a grenade. Ooh, what's some nice lighting effects there. Good shadowing. Alright. Have some more running around, shall we? Try and do some more fighting in this main area. Here we are. Bloody hell. I love this gun so much. I think it was like, oh, where did you come from? But yeah, in the first game, other than the AA-12, this was my favourite gun. Oops. There we go. Wow, well done. Well done! I was thinking strafing into a freaking metal beam there. I just love the way it just launches things backwards. It's like, BOOM! That's why we call it the boomstick, ladies and gentlemen. Where's our last one? Come on, where, oh, there we go. What, okay, right. What is it doing up there? Have I left one of my doors welded? I think I have. Yeah. Hang on, how fast is that going down? Okay, I'm going to have to go and get him. I was going to say, if it was about to break, I'd just throw a grenade up there. But let's go find you. Hey, knock, knock.
Come see me.
Oh, and there's my trader. How about that?
Nicely done.
You know, while we're here. Yeah, again, another room. Completely different to the trader rooms. It's actually quite nice, isn't it? Like some sort of old office area. And you can even see into some of the other areas, which means that I can actually go to the area just down there. I can probably see into the trader room from there. It's quite interesting. And again, a bit of a closer view of what I was showing you before, because it was actually behind the trader area before. But yeah, there you go. That's the room I was in just a minute ago. That's pretty cool. Anyway, see you next wave. Oh, as it turns out, this isn't my trader room, but all the traders open. That's a little bit confusing, can I point out? So, yeah, let's actually get to my correct trader. I did not go down this way. Okay, you know, I might as well just show you my entire route on the way there. But yeah, I think, could it just be me being picky, but I think, don't have all the trader rooms open, otherwise people will run into a room that isn't the trader room and go, why can't I do anything? Yep, we got it. We got it. Just in time. We got my favourite gun, so let's do some fighting in here. Also, can I just say, look at the amount of detail in here. I was so sure I could go down here and actually fight in this room. Oh, God. But yeah, that is really impressive. Of course, the advantage is, while I'm trying to show you this, I can very easily clear the toughest enemies in the room. There we go. I am trying to show this fancy stuff, okay? Wow. That's really nice. I like this. It is a shame you can't, like, at least go over these barricades here so you can have a bit of a closer look at this stuff. Because the thing doesn't just go up and down, it actually goes to all the different areas. And watch it deploy some molten metal as well. And it fills up as well. That's pretty cool. I'll just spend the rest of the wave in here. Oh, wait, hang on. Don't stop me from looking at things. And off it goes, pick up some more. That's pretty cool. I'm just going to watch this, and, you know, occasionally turn around and try not to die. That's really nice. Oh my god. Look, just stop. Yeah, anyways, see you next wave. I like how there's lots of extra side rooms in this bit as well. So much extra detail in this map, I love it. And a great work day starts with a great attitude. Or an AA-12. I think an AA-12 gives me a good attitude. But yeah, this is definitely... Ooh. Yeah. All accidents are your own fault. Okay, I like that. This is definitely one of my top 5 favourite maps of the year. I can quite clearly say that. It's really, really well done. Fortunately, I don't remember the original map well enough to say how accurate a redo of it is. Apparently it is a direct port, so it should be exactly the same, apart from all the upgraded graphics and stuff. Of course, I want to say this because I'm going to kill him in a sec, so... He's not got much time left. Oh god, okay, right, hang on. If I can keep up with him, that is, of course. Ah, great. I actually can't see how far away he is. I can hear you. I can hear you. He's gonna get it. Yeah, I can't get there in time. God damn. Where's he gone to run again? Oh shit. He's jumped off the edge. Where is he? I think it's at the end of this corridor, I can't quite see. It's a shame the rain doesn't actually splash off the top of his head or something. Come on, where are you? He's gonna get this one as well, isn't he? Yeah. There he is. I get there just in time to actually, you know, fail. Come on. Oh great, where's he gone now? Okay, now I've lost him. I was hoping to get in the first time, but oh well. Can't win them all, can you? After all your money on their guns, the life insurance would have been more useful. Little present for you guys. There he is, again, just in time to fail. Okay, that was your last one, so... There we go. And of course, chuck some money on him. Alright, thanks for watching, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.